Hello, my brothers and sisters. Today is day 11 of our consecration. How are you doing? As we draw near to our Blessed Mother, she brings us to Jesus. And so we should be looking for two things. A, that we should be feeling her support, her presence. But oftentimes, the evil one doesn't want us to be closer to our Blessed Mother. He doesn't want this. So he's going to start trying to make it a little bit difficult for us to continue on, push through, continue to cling to her, tell her about it as we journey towards the sun. So we've been talking about Mary being the created Immaculate Conception and the Holy Spirit being the uncreated Immaculate Conception. Because to Saint Bernadette in Lourdes, our Blessed Mother said, I am the Immaculate Conception. Not that I was conceived immaculately, but I am the Immaculate Conception. So what does this tell us? First off, we remember that in the way that we describe the Trinity, St. Thomas Aquinas, he will talk about there being a Father, and the Father begets the Son, and the Son is begotten by the Father. And so that's how their relationship is. But the early church would always express that the love between the Father and the Son was so real that the Holy Spirit was there. And Maximian Kolbe says that that is like a conception. Why does he say that? In the Catechism of the Catholic Church, paragraph 2205, it says this: the Christian family is a communion of persons, a sign and an image of the communion of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. And so this idea of the Holy Spirit being the uncreated conception is not that odd in our Trinitarian thought. And so why Mary says that she is the Immaculate Conception and Kolbe calls her the created Immaculate Conception is just think about this. How close were Mary and the Holy Spirit? The reason why this is important because it shows their closeness. The Holy Spirit was sent to us for power. It's another advocate and a guide. And Mary and the Holy Spirit are like this. They're so close because the Holy Spirit overshadowed her. And they conceived, he conceived a child within her womb in this process. So close does Maximian Kolbe even say, it was like they have this spousal relationship, that Mary is the spouse of the Spirit. Because in our theology of marriage, to become one. And although the Holy Spirit never becomes incarnate, Kolbe even says that if the Holy Spirit was, it would be Mary. And that spousal union is so close. And just like in our culture, that the wife will take the name of the husband, so too, isn't it beautiful that the uncreated Immaculate Conception, that Mary takes the name of the Spirit, the created Immaculate Conception. And that's why Kolbe believes that she, to St. Bernadette at Lourdes, said, I am the Immaculate Conception. What does this mean for us? That not only does Mary lead us to her Son, but she has a very special relationship with the Holy Spirit. And so as we have been gifted the Spirit in our confirmation, the more that we come to know our Blessed Mother, she can also bring us to know her spouse, the Spirit. And so let us ask her to introduce us to the Holy Spirit that gives gifts, that bears fruits, that is powerful within us to help us to go out and to live the power of Jesus in the world. Let us pray our prayers today. Share our blessings, give our intercession to our Blessed Mother, and really ask the Spirit to be alive in us. And ask our Blessed Mother to help us to meet her spouse as she leads us to her Son. God bless. I'll see you tomorrow.